Hello students, today let's start the region of surface tension. As I have already told you about surface tension and simply what is, how can we define surface tension, how can we measure quantitatively the value of surface tension and so on. So today let's know about how can we explain the region to acquire the minimum volume or minimum surface area, or simple why they all liquid drops which have a smaller masses they try to attain the spherical shape. So as I told you that it's due to surface tension, but how can we easily explain it? We can also explain it by the molecular theory of simple. Means as I have already told you, sphere of influence, molecular range, that types of constant and surface film. So I am going to use that three concepts here also. Suppose that this is a liquid vessel and this is the surface film, means the topmost layer of the liquid through which its molecular range work, and also this liquid will this film will be at rest, okay. And this is this circle shows that suppose that I am taking three molecules A, B and C, and this sphere shows that sphere of influence for these molecules. As molecules A lies well inside the liquid, molecule B lies inside the this surface film KLMN, and molecule C lies on the top of the surface film. So we can draw a sphere of influence for each molecules as I have shown you already in figure. So come to the point, this molecule, since molecular ranges or simple molecular forces are working in every possible direction, and this the range of this will be the range of molecular range. So if we will draw simply, or we will connect it by its locus, or simply we draw a sphere, then it will give us a sphere of influence. Means to this area, this molecule A can affect all other molecules. So simply suppose that A is acting in this direction on any molecule and interaction this direction. So you are saying that due to directionality, these all are cancel out to each other, means upper half sphere and lower down this downward half sphere, the forces cancel out each other, and finally if we will conclude net force acting on this molecule, that will be zero. It apply forces on each molecules which are within this region, but if we calculate net force acting on this molecule or acted by this molecule, that will be zero. So in this case, as the upper half forces are equal to the downward half, so that's why it will be simply net force acting on this is zero. Now come to the point, this molecule B. So in this molecule B, as we are seeing that there are large number of molecules affecting by this molecule B in downward direction than in upward direction. So it means that if this will cancel out this, then after that value there will be some net downward forces acting by it. Means simply if upper half portion there will be less molecule than in the downward half portion, then definitely net force acted by this molecule will be in downward direction. Against the same case we can take for the molecule C. As we are seeing, this C is on the top of the film, and there are only downward direction forces, so definitely no molecules or in the opposite direction to these forces, and definitely it will exert a downward force on other lower molecules. So simple the conclusion is that if any molecule will lie within this spherical film, then there will be some net downward forces acting on acting, and due to that downward forces, definitely the liquid will attain some additional potential energy. So I think firstly this concept is now clear to you. If we will calculate net forces acting by this, and then simply here the net force will be zero. Here some of the net force will be attained, and here basically some the highest or maximum force exert by the molecule that will lie on the top of the surface film. So finally, this surface film, all molecules lies in that surface film, will exert a net downward force. And due to that downward force, definitely if we want to break any molecular bond, or we want to make free to any molecule, then we have to add some additional energy. Or if molecule wants to leave the surface, then it must have to do some work on the against of this downward cohesive forces. Since I am taking the same liquid, and these are molecules of the same substance, so that's why the force acting here, that will be cohesive force obviously. So the force of cohesion means they have to do some work done against this force of cohesion which is acting in downward direction. So that work done will be stored in this liquid as the potential energy. So means in this all process, due to all molecules lies in the surface film, and due to their action of downward cohesive forces, liquid attains additional potential energy, and due to that additional potential energy, it will tend to get some minimum surface area to maintain its stability. As you know that every liquid surface or every body wants to be in its stable equilibrium, and to attain that stable equilibrium, it must have minimum additional potential energy. So obviously, if here the potential energy will be minimum if number of molecules in this surface film will be minimum. But if number of molecules in this surface film will be greater, then definitely there will be some greater potential energy. So due to that equilibrium or simple stable equilibrium will not attain by the body, and body will be unstable. So to attain the stability, they always tend to attain simply minimum additional potential energy, and there is only one process, that is there must be minimum number of molecules lying in this surface film. So if there will be minimum number of molecules, then definitely net downward cohesion will be simply minimized. So for the minimum potential energy or minimum number of molecules, surface must have minimum volume, and for minimum volume they must have some minimum surface area. And you know that in all shapes sphere has minimum surface area, so that's why all liquid tends to acquire spherical shape, or simply they tend to them make in spherical ball or spherical drops to attain this stable equilibrium, because sphere has minimum surface area, and that provides them there will be minimum number of molecules lies in the surface film. And if minimum number of molecules lies in the surface film, then definitely there will be minimum additional potential energy. So this is the molecular concept of surface tension. Means simply you can say that due to downward cohesive forces, there will be always an action of tension in downward direction in the any film. Means if any liquid or any molecule try to escape from this surface, then it will feel some opposite force. Means that opposite force will be force of cohesion, and it must have to do some work against it. This there will be a tension acting in the inside simple tension will act in this body or simply in liquids, and that tension will be like a stressed membrane, and that's why this is the region of surface tension. Means simply the production of cohesive downward forces are responsible for the surface tension, and the direction of surface tension is always tends to the center of the sphere. So I think now with molecular theory it's simply clear to you why there is additional potential energy possessed by any liquid in its surface film, and why liquid acquire or liquid simply droplets acquire spherical shape. Simply why I'm saying that droplet or smaller mass, because if mass will be higher, then there will be the role of gravity countable. Then if role of gravity will be countable, then definitely there will be some distortion in shape occurs, as you have seen that for larger mass the shape becomes some like elliptical and so on. So that's why I'm already taking the case where the effect of gravity is smaller, so we are not taking that into account. So smaller droplets are simply spherical in shape, and the region is this. So I think molecular theory of surface tension is clear to you why surface tension is acting, and how can we explain simply potential energy term and spherical shape of any liquid droplet. So let's see, obviously if they are possessing additional potential energy, then we can also call it surface energy. So what will be the surface energy, how much potential energy they will acquire due to this action of downward cohesive forces. So let's see that. So now let's see what is surface energy. As I've told you, simply surface energy is nothing but the potential energy required to simply increase the area of any surface film. As you know that I've already told you with the help of molecular theory that every surface film has additional potential energy, and due to their net downward cohesive forces. So obviously if we want to increase the area of that surface or simply liquid, then definitely we have to do some work against that potential energy stored in that surface film. So the amount of work to be done to increase that surface simply surface area is known as simply surface energy. So simply this is also a form of potential energies. So I think it's very simply clear to you, we have to calculate work done to increase work in increasing the area of any surface film that will be simply stored in the body as the surface energy. So for calculation, let's see, there is a rectangular simply loop A, B, C, D, and here we have taken a film of soap PBDQ. Okay, as you know that in case of soap there are two surface films in air and soap bubble, so there will be definitely two always two films. And now let S is the surface tension acting due to the simply net cohesive forces on the due to the surface film. So if S is the simply surface tension, we can easily calculate what will be the net down inward forces or downward forces in this film. So that will be equal to, as you know that surface tension is equal to F upon L. Okay, or and in this case we are taking soap bubbles, so definitely there will be the length of two films, that will be 2L. So we can easily calculate what will be the net force acting in inward direction, that will be S into 2L. Okay. Now suppose that we are increasing area of this film by applying any force F on it, and let's start, suppose that the increase in area is delta A, and due to application of this force, suppose there is the displacement x occur in the simply this film. So if x will be the displacement occurred in the film, then definitely we can find out simply the area increased, which will be simple 2 times L into x. Again, 2 are used for the 2 surface films, so don't be confused here, because we are taking the case of soap bubble. If you will take any other case, then you don't have to write 2 here. Only if will suppose that if water film is inside this rectangular loop, then in for the water case there will be only one film, and if there will be only one film, then definitely here will be F upon L only, and also here you don't have to write 2. That in that case you will get the same equation with that with the help of water film or with the help of soap film. So I think it's not the confusing point that why I'm taking all these 2 here. So 2 is used, multiplication of 2 is used only for the 2 surface film produced in case of soap. Okay. So simply, what will be the area of one film? That will be L into x, increased area. So in this case, there will be 2Lx. Clear? Now to increase this area, we as I told you that every surface has some additional potential energy, or simple, there must be some work against this surface tension to increase the area of a surface. So that work will be also simply equal to F into x, means force applied, and to this displacement simply x, as we have displaced simple or increased area of the film by x. So we can easily calculate it. Value of F is this, S into 2L, and this is x. As you know that this value is already delta A, we can write it here. Means work done comes to be W equal to S into delta A. Okay. And I've already told you that surface energy is the work done to increase the area of the surface film against the surface tension or against the additional potential energy. So this work will be stored as the surface area, surface energy in the liquid. So surface energy will be simply nothing but that will be equal to the work done on increasing, simply work in increasing this surface area of the film. So that will be comes to S into delta A. So we can easily calculate what will be the surface energy if you know the surface tension of the liquid, or simply net forces acting in what direction. So we can easily calculate it. Also we can calculate the surface tension from here. That will be surface energy per unit area. Means in unit area, the energy possessed by any surface is known as surface tension. Simple. So I think now the concept of surface energy is clear to you. Simple. If we want to increase, or if any liquid surface wants to increase its surface area, then definitely it have to do some work against the inward cohesive force or additional potential energy, and that work done is known as the surface energy of that liquid surface. So that surface energy will be equal to this value. So if there is no problem, also you can calculate surface tension from here. You can also measure surface tension in form of energy, as you have already figured it in form of force. Okay. So now let's see what is the axis of pressure on the curved surface of the liquid. As you know that simply surface of force of surface tension act tangentially in what direction, and also means act tangentially to the surface of the liquid film. So if shape of the liquid film surface will be different, then definitely the action of resultant force will be different. So if we will find out resultant force acting in the different surface film, that will depends on the shape of that surface film, and due to that shape or different resultant force, there will be some concept of excess of pressure. Let's see how. suppose that for in first case, if the surface of the film is plane, simply if it's plane, then let's suppose that there is a point O, and that definitely you know that the surface force of surface tension act tangentially to the this surface film, then it will act in the tangential direction, and definitely it will cancel out to each other. So because they are acting as the normally to this surface, so if simply means in the tangential direction, and they both are cancel out each other simple. So due to the cancelling property here, no net resulting force will be acted. So if net resultant force will be zero, then definitely there will be no concept of excess of pressure here. Only the pressure of here will be normal atmospheric pressure, and that will depends on the height and other factor. But due to this surface tension or force of surface tension, there will be no any action of any resultant force and simple excess of pressure simple, because net resultant force is zero here. I think that's clear to you. Now let's the concept of simple, if the plane is convex or concave. So if plane is suppose that convex, in this case means they have, if simply plane are curved surface. So for the curved surface, there will be always also action of simple surface tension in tangential direction. And if there is the tangential direction, then as you have seen, you are seeing that these tangential directions are different, and we can easily find out their horizontal and vertical components. So horizontal components of these surface tensions will cancel out each other, but the vertical components will add up. So due to the addition of vertical component, there will be some net resultant force acting in downward direction, and due to that resultant force, definitely there will be the action of net force. And if you will calculate force per unit area, then definitely there will be some pressure exerting in downward direction, and that pressure is known as excess pressure. So in convex simply cases, convex curved surface, you are seeing that force of action or net resultant force is acting in downward direction. So simple in curved surface area, there is a excess of pressure present due to this convex surface or concave surface. Let's see also the case of concave surface. So first I am telling you the case of convex surface. So I think now this is simply clear to you. You have to simply take the components of them, and these two components, horizontal components will cancel out, and vertical components will be added up simply, and due to their addition simply there will be the action of net resultant force in downward direction, and due to that force definitely there will be some pressure acting in downward direction. Okay, and that pressure is the excess pressure on this convex surface. Sorry guys. So let's take the example of one or other curved surface, that is the concave surface. So in case of concave surface, as you are seeing that again we can there will be the direction of surface tension in tangential direction, and again we can calculate the horizontal and vertical component here, and again in this case horizontal components of this surface tension will cancel out each other, but the vertical components will be again added up in the upward direction. So there will be a net upward force acting on the this concave surface, and due to that upward forces, there will be simply an excess pressure generated. And so that's why I have already told you why there is the presence of excess pressure. If there is the action of surface tension, means if liquid is at rest, it depends on that which types of surface film is forming. If there is a curved surface film, then definitely there will be some excess force acting on the body. So if this is clear to you, one more thing is here. If body is at rest or liquid is at rest, then definitely there must be some equilibrium setup. It means that in The excess pressure here will be cancelled out with the help of surface tension, which is acting in the upward direction finally. So in case of, actually you know that in case of film, there is action of force in inward direction. So in case of concave surfaces, excess pressure will be greater than in case of convex surfaces, as they are already acting in the downward direction, and that obviously this downward direction force also supported by other forces. So that's why this force will be less than in case of concave surfaces, because there are so many opposing forces in this direction. So the value of concave this force must be greater than the some extent to concave surface. So convex surface. So I think simply the concept of excess of pressure on the curved surface is clear to you. Simple, if there will be any curved surface, then there will be the net resultant force which the direction of which is acting towards the center of curvature of that curved surface, and due to that resultant force there will be some excess pressure generated in the simple liquid. So if the concept of excess of pressure is clear to you, then we can easily calculate what will be the expression for excess of pressure, and I will tell you how can we calculate excess pressure for simple water film or air bubble or soap bubble. So how can we calculate in that case? So let's see that what will be the mathematical calculation or mathematical formula for the calculation of excess of pressure. So let's see how to calculate excess of pressure inside a liquid drop. So suppose this is a liquid drop and this is point P. So definitely you know that there will be the action of force of surface tension in inward direction, and as you know that due to surface tension the size of liquid drop cannot be zero. So to maintain the size of liquid drop, there will be the action of some forces in outward direction. Means to attain the equilibrium condition, stable condition, there will be some outward forces acting on the liquid surface which will counterbalance to the simply surface tension inside the liquid. So suppose that these are also outward forces, and definitely the direction of them will be also normal to the this surface of the film, as surface tension act normally to the this in inward direction. So that's why this will be in outward direction normally. So I think this is simply clear to you. Suppose that the radius of this is capital R. So let's S is the surface tension of liquid, P0 is atmospheric pressure on this liquid surface, and Pi is the total pressure inside the liquid drop. So simply if due to this surface tension, this shape of the film, then net inward forces acting inside the inward direction. So what will be the excess pressure experienced by this liquid drop? That will be simply Pi minus P0. If Pi is total pressure experienced by it, this liquid surface, then and P0 is the atmospheric pressure in opposite direction, then what will be the total excess pressure acting on that? That will be Pi minus P0. Okay. So let's calculate simple. As you also told Telik that if excess of pressure is acting inside the body, then as I have told you to maintain their stable equilibrium, there will be some action of forces in outward direction, and obviously if in outward direction some forces are acting, so they will tend to increase its surface area, and it means that they will possess some surface energy. And suppose that delta R radius is increased in this case, so simply to increase delta R, surface must have to do some work. So let's see how much work it is done by this and with that concept we can easily calculate what will be the axis of pressure. Let's see how we can calculate it. So firstly, I think this concept is normally clear to you. What is the axis of pressure inside a liquid drop? Simple, it's very simple. As you know that there is net force of cohesion acting in inward direction, and you can also assume that due to that action of inward forces, size of liquid drop can be zero. But as you know that they have to maintain their stable equilibrium, so definitely to maintain them there will be some opposite forces acting in outward direction. So simply to maintain their stable equilibrium, so that's why they tends to increase their area by some amount. And also you know that means they will possess some surface energy by doing some work against the surface tension, means force of surface tension, and due to that surface energy, possession of that surface energy, their liquid drop will be in stable equilibrium, means inward forces will be cancelled out to outward forces, and finally an stable equilibrium will be